Hi, my name is Diane. My objective to doing this podcast is to try to give people a place to ask questions from someone who may have an answer. If not, I'll get them with a lot of luck. Hopefully it will be informative as well as maybe sad at times. I've been in addiction for 25 years. I've got a lot of memories working in addiction. Some funny stories. I've also been a mother of an addict and gone through the stealing, selling of personal items, going to jail, going to rehab, the get me out of here when he was locked up, the hard answer of no, you need to be there, understand what you've done wrong, going through the death of a child, going through the ex-husband of blaming me because I didn't fix him. I tried to make them understand the only way to, you know, there's no fixing somebody else. You have to let them go through the process. They need to fix themselves. You can only give them the tools to do that. Like I said, I've got several people that will come on the podcast with me. Some people that have been through methadone and recovered, how it helped them, how it hindered them. Some people that have been on buprenorphine, how it's helped them, how it's hindered them. I've got a doctor that will come on with me, hopefully. Actually, a couple of doctors I know that may come on. So you'll have your chance to ask the questions of those people. As well as myself. So, if you have any questions, please feel free to email me. My email address is dwood.4@yahoo.com. I have my son's journals, so I'd like to share some of his poetry, some of his stories. Maybe some of his artwork. The differences that the way he wrote between the time he was free of illicit substances as well as under the influence, and see the difference in the tones, in the habits, in the feelings. It's dramatically different. I want to also give you a methadone awareness test. NIDA put out a lot of articles, issues, and things to help train both patients and family members as well as staff. It will help you to learn, help you, show you some of the myths, some of the facts, try to alleviate some of the misconceptions. People who are patients the addiction takes over and becomes an illness. Most people don't understand addiction, but once they've used opiates to the point they're addicted, be it from prescriptions or otherwise, the opiates fill up those pleasure receptors in the brain, and that's when they become addicted. Until they have a way of getting their body back to normal, the addiction is an illness because the brain isn't functioning correctly. And that's the part people don't understand. Those pleasure receptors become so clogged with the opiates that it's not working right. And until that's fixed, the illness has taken over the body. So there's lots of ways to get over that and to make your body well. Just like cigarette smoking, there's lots of ways of getting through that. You have to find the way that is the best for you. Again, there's lots and lots of ways, and nobody can find the best way for you. You need to work through different ways that will work for you. And until you find the right one, obviously, you're not going to get well. Families need to understand that piece. And it's not easy. You have to, like I said, work through it one step at a time. So let's do the methadone awareness test. I'm going to give you the questions this week. Next week, we're going to do the answers. So, question one, is methadone trading one addiction for another? All of these questions, by the way, are true or false answers. So number two, pregnant women should withdraw or at least lower their dose of methadone so that the baby is not born dependent. Number three, methadone gets into the bone marrow, rots the teeth, and depletes the calcium. Number four, methadone suppresses the immune system so that HIV-positive patients should be encouraged to withdraw. Number five, if it is necessary for a methadone patient to take pain medicine, they do not need strong narcotics because the methadone will block the pain. Number six, methadone causes patients to become alcoholics and or cocaine abusers. Number seven, methadone is more addicting than heroin. Number eight, methadone patients should not be allowed to operate heavy equipment or drive a car. Number nine, methadone was named for Adolf Hitler. Number 10, when they do autopsies on methadone patients, the patient's internal organs are dyed bright orange. So those are the 10 questions. You score 10 points for each question you answer correctly. So next week we'll go over all the answers. Hopefully you score 100. Again, my email address is dwood.4@yahoo.com. For any questions you may have, please feel free to ask. I'll do my best to answer them. Um, talk to you soon. Bye.